Himself right beside the senator.
I am Abdulfatai Buhari, former deputy chief of staff for your state.
You're most welcome, sir. And also, for your information, this program will be live because we have our associates. This is the Maiden edition of the Southwest Group of Online Publishers Breakfast Media Chat. The first of its kind anywhere in Oyo State in the Southwest. And our associates from Splash FM are here. We have AIT here. And by the way, we'll be live on radio. So it's going to be something great here. And of course, we have sent questions. We have given people the caveat to send their questions online. So, Senator, we have people even on the internet sending in their questions. But before we go on, I would like to, chairman is not here right now. He apologized. He has something to attend to, a court matter. So he has to be away. He sends his regards, sir. But here we have someone to read his welcome address on his behalf. So can we please have Mr. Larry Agiri?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here to present the speech of the chairman of this forum, Comrade Inka Agbola. It's unavoidably absent due to the problem that we do have. Somebody took us to court concerning a story that was public. So the matter is being here today. Being a speech delivered by the pro tem chairman, Southwest Group of Online Publishers, SWEGO, Mr. Olayinka Agbola, during the hosting of Senator Abdulfatai Buhari of Oyo North Senatorial District at its Maiden Breakfast Chat program, today, November 30th, 2016. Distinguished Senator Abdulfatai Buhari, the chairman Senate Committee on ICT and Cybercrime, item officer of SWEGO, fellow online journalist, ladies and gentlemen. This is no way I can succinctly describe how I feel today as we hold the very first edition of our breakfast chat here at Southwest Group of Online Publishers, SWEGO. It is therefore my sincere pleasure to welcome all to this novel media event. SWEGO, as we happily christen this group, is made up of upwardly mobile journalists who ply their journalistic trade on the internet using different platforms with different device focus. We are all united in our quest to ensure balanced reportage, fairness, respect for ethics. This group was conceived last year after similar attempt to form an equally similar association field. However, SWEGO's approach is different, and we are already interacting with our colleagues throughout the southwest of Nigeria so that we can speak with one voice throughout this geopolitical zone. As earlier enunciated, we are extremely happy that we have somebody of the caliber of Senator Abdulfatai Buhari as our very first guest on this program. For those who do not know, this distinguished lawmaker here is a friend of the media. He, however, one way or the other, wants to look at it. He is indeed a true friend who believes so much in the uplift of journalistic profession. for this purpose of clarity, I will state here that I am one of his admirers. This is not because he's today a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, but because I like to point it out earlier, he is our friend indeed. Distinguished senator, you may have forgotten, but those of us who appreciated what you did for Komri Wale Ojulari during his first time as chairman of Oyo State Council of Nigerian Union of Journalists, NUJ, cannot forget you in a hurry. Fellow tribal member, you may not believe it is during this time I'm referring to the then Honorable Fatai Buhari bought a brand new Peugeot car for the then chairman of NUJ as an official vehicle. He has since that time been proudly associating with us as media practitioner. Today, as I welcome this enigmatic and jolly good fellow, Senator Buhari, to our midst, I wish to let him know that I believe that this is the beginning of greater things to happen to him as a politician. Because by befriending online publisher, he is honestly displaying his fact that he's planning and looking into the future. The online publishing is the future. He has started a very exciting journey today, and he can be well assured that Swego will be ready at all times to add value to whatever he does. Once again, I welcome our distinguished senator guest. Thank you all for rapt listening to this speech. God bless you.
Thank you so much. That was a goodwill message from the chairman of the group, Mr. Anyanka Agboola. And distinguished senator, sir, please permit us to take a 10-minute break we'll be going for a breakfast break, a short one, 10 minutes. Thank you, sir. The organizers have suggested we proceed, sir, in view of the fact that we are live on air, especially as Splash FM has put us on air live. So, distinguished senator, permit me to open with this, sir. The NCC has issued a directive that data tariffs should rise from tomorrow. And, sir, we are online publishers, and we know the future of every business is online. What? And you are the, thank God we have you as the chairman of the Senate Committee on ICT. This tariff increase, one, is it properly timed? Two, what does it portend for ICT in Nigeria?
Well, thank you very much. I must be honest with you. On the issue of that tariff, the National Assembly, we have not been consulted about it. I think it's a policy issue for them. However, I absolutely agree with you that if we say we are in recession, if we say people purchasing power of the people have gone down, this is not the time to milk them. I absolutely agree with you on that. I will call a meeting of my members next week. We'll review it, we'll ask them, and then we'll communicate with them. We will not sit down to allow Nigerians to be milked and sucked. No. No. And I said no. However, we are not in the position to dabble into a policy making of an organization, but we are there to do what is called check and balancing. That this is good, this is not good. So when there are policy like that, the moment it go inimical to the wish of the people, and it's going to affect our society. That is the reason why we should come in, and we will not ask them, why did you do this? Having said this, that is the, on the populist. On the economic part of it, we already agree that, look, we have to look inwards to make ICT one of the center of revenue generating farm or operation for the system. All over the world, ICT contributes to some certain percentage of the income of most countries. So if we agree that we need to look elsewhere for the source of income to the country, if you look at it from that angle and from the government side, they may have their reason. But I agree that 100% increment is not something that is acceptable. Even if you are going to increase it, you go what is called gradually, so that the effect will be minimal on the poor people.
And well, let's open the...
Thank you very much, sir. Bisi Aladele is my name. Nigeria is, going by what we read in the papers every day, Nigeria is adjudged as one of the countries filled with internet scams, people that use the internet to commit fraud, to deal people, particularly from within and outside the country. As the chairman of ICT, of Senate Committee on ICT and Cybercrime, can you please share with us at what percentage is this cybercrime growing in Nigeria? Or if it is decreasing, at what percentage, particularly in the last 4 years?
It is not decreasing at all in Nigeria. As of the moment, the rate of cybercrime in our country is horrible. And that's one of the reasons why I accepted your invitation, because the intention is that the moment you guys are able to form yourself into a group, you'll be able to assist the government in facing these challenges. Sometimes early this year, I was in Korea, and I was asking the chairman of ICT in their Senate, in their parliament, that what is the rate of the attack on cyber crimes, your cyber system. Leon Chun told me, he said, 0%, 100% free. I look at him and say, what do you mean? What is 0% and 100% free? He said they have what is called gate stop. They don't allow you to come into their system, talk less of attacking them. Mm. So most of the time, they stop at the gate. So the moment any attack is coming, they have that mechanism. And if you are conversant with what is called cybercrime, and you go to where they have the site, in all of these ICTs, if you see the rate of attack, particularly from China and Russia, if America today is even shouting that his system has been hacked, you can really know what is going on, talk less of some of us, so talk less of our country that has no any protection. Having said this, this year alone, United Kingdom budgeted £22 billion. Listen, £22 billion for cyber security. American budgeted, say, $43 billion to fight cybercrime. Nigeria budgeted zero naira to fight cybercrime. And then this is something that is endemic in our system. The truth of the matter is that if you want to fight a cyber crime, it is something that involves a lot of money. A lot of money. The success of it will help your economy, and it will help business partner or foreign partner that are looking forward to do business with you, to give them confidence. We have Galaxy Backbone. We have NICOMSAT. We have NISDA. We have MINS, that's National Identity Card Commission. All these ICT center are what I oversight. When you go on oversight to these people and you see the equipment they have, you'll be marveled. But they don't have what is called coordination. They don't have what is called coordination. NICOMSAT alone have a system with Galaxy Backbone where they can store all the data of this country. They have it. But everybody is afraid of them because there is no what is called a second backup. If you don't have a second backup, I will not bring my sister. Suppose there is a crash, what happened to my sister? That's the reason why we are struggling, that since we already have a very solid one, we can get a backup. We will now pass a law that all service providers must go and use NICOMSAT, so that that will be an income generating farm for the organization, for the country. But if you are unable to do this, we will still be talking of story and history every day, the way we continue to do.
So at what rate can you say cybercrime is growing in Nigeria?
It's really growing at an astronomical rate. It's very high. I don't have the offhand percentage, but it's horrible. You said something that I absolutely agree with you. We have guys who are talented in this country that will have been able to use as a genius to use it to get revenue for this country, but unfortunately for all, they use it in opposite direction. Sometime last year, we were in the United Nations in America, in New York, when a lady was presenting her paper to God Almighty, God, I was flabbergasted and angry, because when the woman was talking, she was from Eritrea. He was not talking of ICT and the way they'd be able to use ICT in their country, blah, 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 blah. Suddenly from nowhere, she now said they have that capacity. They don't have oil in their country, but they have capacity to be able to match the people that have oil like Nigeria, that don't know what to do with their talents and the opportunity. Oh, God. Though, when the opportunity came back for us to give it to her back, we were able to reply her appropriately. But the truth of the matter is that when we went back to our own hotel, when we were this United States, this woman, and she really hit us, that's in our own corner. Though we gave it to her back, that look, the total population of your country, you are less than 10 million, which is less than the state where I come from. That's all your state. Talk less of a population of country we have. If a Nigeria had been 10 million, America would have been coming here, India would have come here, China would have been coming here to learn, because we'll be able to manage whatever we have to match our population. So what is it that you're talking about? A complex society, a country like Nigeria, is something that is part of the problem we have in this country. I'm sorry, with due respect, we are too big. Too big, and then everybody is intelligent and thinking about themselves. Like, and whenever I have opportunity to talk on Nigerian issue like this, there's one thing that always crossed my mind, that I always appreciate in my life, that I will appreciate in my life if it happened. The day I see Nigeria seeing themselves as a Nigerian, not as a Yoruba man or Igbo man or an Hausa man, that will be one of the happiest day in my life, because the moment you see that, there's what is called unity, and we have come of age.
Mr. Deputy Senator, I'm Oluwaseun Akintola from Splash FM. At the Senate, do you have any bill that is talking about 9% communication tax?
It's not 9%. There's a bill. I don't know the percentage of it. It is true, there's a bill. It's an existing law. It came into existence immediately they were introducing MTN and then the cellular phone back in the 1999. But of Edna, I cannot remember the answer. But I know of another 2% that is called tax from the service provider that they are supposed to remit back so that they can use it for the society. But the 9%, sincerely, I know there's a percentage communication tax. I can't remember the percentage of it. I can easily give you the figure in the next 15 minutes after we finish. I will just go to my office.
Okay. At the moment, a research has shown that Nigerians spend the average of 18% of the salaries on internet broadband.
Yeah.
And we are losing billions of naira to cybercrime. Internet broadband charge has increased. And then we're talking about these internet of hacks.
Yes.
What are you going to do as senators to save Nigerians, to save these people from their business, because they may be losing their businesses?
They can't lose their business. Because the reason why I say this is that passing the law is not the issue. The implementation is the biggest problem we have in this country. If we look at the way things are going and we say, okay, let's amend this law, the ball comes on the table of my own committee. We can take it up and send it. But let me give you a shocker. A cybercrime law. Most people were shocked. The other day we were having public hearing. When we told them that there is a cybercrime law, they didn't even know that it exists. But Jonathan signed it into law shortly before he left. It's 7 years improvement. That's why I was laughing when you were telling me one of your guys is in court now to face some certain. It's 7 years labor. And I'm seizing the opportunity to appeal to those of us online. Social media is used as a check and balancing of the society, genuinely, honestly, not as a destruction. You don't use it to fight. That's what it, the way it is done all over the world. Sorry, all over an advanced world. Because even there is a law that regulates it. But people in Nigeria believe that, look, I'm of no fixed address. The moment I don't like your face, I can destroy you based on life. That's not good. One of my joy today is that, oh, if people are trying to gather yourself. So if now, if for example, I saw something online on Parrot, I can easily write the software that, look at what your member has done. First in line as a protest. And then by the time I receive a reply, such a person can be taking that, look, why did you do this? Is it true? You say, look, I stand by my story. It is true. You can see that there's a line of communication. The moment I know that he's lying, I have the right as a Nigerian to go to court. But the moment every other Tom, Dick, and Harry write, it will not give this association what is called integrity. But we need it to succeed. We need it to survive. We need it to help the society. But the moment we have a situation where every Tom, Dick, and Harry just big social distancing that I want to use it as a destruction, it will not help the country. We should be able to use this, our talent, to help the economy, to help our country, so that the country can be taken to where we ought to be, not where we are presently.
Distinguished Senator, sir, my name is Omolere Omoito from oyoforum.com. And the question I want to ask is that internet fraud is one of the things that Nigerians are quite known for. I want to ask, what is your committee doing presently or have done to curb these activities? And are there countries you're talking with, collaborating with, to also help in fighting internet fraud in Nigeria, particularly among the youth?
We set up a committee about 2 months ago. That committee is being headed by my deputy, Ogola Foster, Senator Ogola Foster from Bayelsa. We're having what is called Cybercrime Conference. I think the date is on the 17th or 18th. I'm not too sure because they've not given all the details. And we've called all everybody in communication sector that will participate. These are some of the things we intend to discuss. You see, in the conference, when you allow all the stakeholders to come, by the time you gather experience, by the time you gather every other person, and you now take it up as a law, it will become strange because everybody is involved. I agree with you. If you look at the British budget, like I told you earlier, they budgeted 22 billion. When they were mentioning country, they mentioned Bangladesh, they mentioned India. Nigeria was number 4th country they mentioned on cyber or on internet fraud. Okay. You know, when you see things negatively about your country, you're a human being, you feel ashamed. But when they are truth, you and I know the way our boys do. And that's what I'm saying. And we now want to have a relationship, even with almost everybody by the time we registered, that we have a relationship to be able to turn that negative thought into positivity. Because if you're able to let them know that if you commit a fraud, you'll be able to make 10 naira. If you make 10 naira and you are caught, you go for 10 years. But if you're able to use this talent, genuinely, the way it should be done, you can make 100 naira. 100 naira is more than 10 naira. You'll be able to use that and people will be proud of you. Let me tell you, one of my happiest days since I became a senator was about 3 months ago. The president went to America. While in America, coincidentally, I was in America at that time. So we were now gisting with some of our colleagues that were there at the lobby of the hotel. A guy just came in. So when he came in, Fayemi was now talking to the guy. Another person I was standing with now said, that guy is from Nigeria. He's the best designer, auto designer in the whole of America. They are bringing him here to say, what? I said, when you look at the guy, a young guy, a very young guy, the most annoying thing or the most funny thing, he's from Sokoto. I haven't took a picture with him. Now imagine, I'm sorry, with due respect, I'm not ridiculing anybody. Now imagine the type of talent we'll have in Enugu, the type of talent we'll have in Ibadan, the type of talent we'll have in Lagos. Okay. If that guy was to stay in Nigeria, it would have been an Alimagiri. Look at the way they were able, which means we have the potential. It's a standard Google it. You see, Mohammed Ilya. Google it. You see, from Sokoto, look at the young guy. Look at our phone. One day, I was at home with my daughter and I was watching football. Unfortunately, they were leading my team. So my hair was straight. She now came, she was fiddling with the, what is this? I said, Daddy, don't worry, I won't disturb you, don't go. She also wanted to do something on laptop, but she needed to connect it with my TV. I said, no, go upstairs. I said, Daddy, don't worry. By the time I realized it, she did everything. She now said, I didn't answer. I just finished watching my ball when we equalized. I was happy. Little after the match, and I said, Combo, how did you do that? They say, Chairman ICT. Because this is the truth. I'm referring to. Yeah, she is not an ICT expert, but the way they handle our phone or this size, you'll be marvel. She was teasing Mr. Chairman ICT. I said, yeah, that is the truth. You can see. Even I've got to most of us. Before I became the ICT chairman, I must be honest with you. I was always thinking, oh, I'm a smart guy, this and that. But what I've seen on that field within the last 2 years, and I knew I was a bloody illiterate on that line. You go now, I don't know what is called cloud internet, broadband, when we are just already on internet, they have gone. I went to South Korea, because South Korea, they don't have any oil, they don't have anything, they have the best refinery in the world. And then when I went there, when you see the way they juggle with ICT, I say, oh my God. Can we reach here? Can we reach here? Even in their Senate ICT department, I was just laughing because the guy was doesn't mean so. I didn't want to look like Aroko-ish with him. I said, oh, okay. I was just there because most of the thing I'm seeing them for the first time when he took us to where they call a gate stop. You see, they don't allow the attack to come, so the attack will be hitting the wall, will be hitting the papa in every seconds. So that's why he was able to say, we're 100% free. Is it? 99% free because everything 24/7 somebody's manning the place 24/7 they are changing, they are taking the attack, and particularly with what is happening between the south and the north, they must be on alert, but they have gone far ahead. So back to you raised, it is something we can do together. And I'm seizing this opportunity to invite this organization to that conference. Formal letter will come. So that by the time you come with your own input too, before you realize it, we are helping our country.
But sir, do you see us getting to that level where we'll be?
Never say never.
Where we'll say
never say never. Let me give you something that has happened in this country that can give you hope. 1999 election. Compare it to 2003 election. The 2003 election is better than the 1999, arguably. 2003 election with 2011. The 2011 election is better than 2003. Ditto 2015 election. My mother does not know anything that is called PVC. academic. It is called practice every day, improve or heal, accept commitment, do what you can do. We can go there. We will be able to. I was watching the American election live when on the 9th of November. You will be amazed. The way they were finishing result is coming from the southwest. So Indiana is coming, Mississippi is coming, this is coming. It looks like there was no anything. This is Finching, it's ICT. We can reach there. It's gradually, but all what is needed is a determination from you, from me, from every other person that is involved. It is true the level of illiterate is higher here, but it's not everybody that is America that is also literate. They have their own illiterate too. It's not all of them that are education. All what we needed is what is called reorientation of our people and the love for the country.
Okay. Distinguished Senator, sir, I understand that you have interest in petroleum sector as well. When you were in the House of the House of Representatives, you're also very much interested in the petroleum sector. The petroleum industry bill has stalled at the National Assembly for quite some time, as a matter of fact, for ages. You are a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Look at the petroleum sector. It is in coma. What are you going to do about it? Or maybe I should have asked the question, what have you done about the PIB?
The PIB bill was passed last week, Wednesday. If you are following, if you follow up the trend of the Senate, you will have known. It was brought by a distinguished senator, Alasho Adura, who is the chairman of Petroleum Upstream. He brought it and we passed it. It has gone to a committee level. All what we are waiting for is for the House to concur. If the House concur, we now send it for assent.
Oruko temi ni Kola Oladapo lati Lagiri FM. Gege bi awon oro te so siwaju. Gege bi awon oro te so siwaju ati awon irinajo te ti rin lo so le South Africa ta me orilede America nipa tun se pelu ICT. Bi opolopo awon eyan se nlo ori ero ayelukara fun iwo daran. Papa julo lo le de Nigeria. Gege bi awon iriri ati awon idanileko te ti gbagbo. Njẹ igbimọ yin ti se agbekale ilana atẹle kan ta mọsi boya policy lati ma se amulo awon eyan to je pe won lo ero ayelukara fun iwo daran lati ma yọ opolo won pada ki bo si ma wulo for lady ati fun tesiwaju ni Nigeria.
Well, I manage you ba mi ni o. Anyway, I ododo tin bembe ni wi pe ofin be tele tele I bikita pẹ̀lú àwọn ènìyàn àwọn ará orílẹ̀-èdè àtàwọn agbófinduro náà ni òjè ká máa mú àwọn òfin wa lò. Bí mo ṣe sọ níbi ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ yìí tẹ́lẹ̀ yìí pé èèyàn pípọ̀ gan ni ọmọ ibi inú àwa tá à ń ṣiṣẹ́ oníròyìn afẹ́fẹ́ àìmọ̀ yìí pé òfin bẹ lórí cyber crime. Èyí tí kàn bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ni pé òfin yẹn á mú lò bó ṣe yẹ kí wọ́n mú lò. So àwọn tí ń lò àwọn tó ń ṣiṣẹ́ yẹn wọ́n kàn ṣe ìwà ìbìkítà ni èyí tó ń dunní jù ni wípé wọn ò ṣe láti fi ràn lú lọ́wọ́ wọ́n kàn ṣe fún orí ara wọn àti fi bàyẹ jẹ́ ìní bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe kóra yín jọ yìí tẹ ẹ pawọ́ pọ̀ tí wọ́n bá lè ṣe tẹ́yìn náà ń ṣe yìí nílùú south east tí wọ́n ṣe north east tẹ wá tún padà lọ ní national body tó ṣe pé fúnra ara yín gan ẹ ti ń bára yín wí tẹ bá rẹ ni tó ṣe pé kíní. Offensive wabaje, two marry if you are buying, two mako abayin, tell now disciplinary committee 13 chinto yakan yoshi, and niriwa mwa wabaje yima. I be oko waga ajika mwa lutin beru, lati waba wa se obu. Aje kokon woli mape ufimbe. Bobo yori lady ni kaluku a mwodana mabe. Aman to li pofimbe, uji ki kaluku o sora toma koto ba lufi, toma gomu ufio la no feni kaka.
Mr. Lady. Sir, civil service is the operation, the operational, how the civil service is run in this country is a concern to very many Nigerians. And ICT, as you are preaching, will be a veritable instrument that we believe the Nigerian civil service should embrace. Is there anything your committee is doing to push that? To ensure that the entire civil service embraces ICT, that our entire operations are computerized to save time, for clarity, for precision, and several other advantages. Is there anything you are doing to push that very seriously for that matter?
The process is already ongoing. I just told you I went to South Korea. That was what we went for. It's called e-learning, e-government, e-parliamentary. Everything abroad now is electronic transactions. So the e-government, there's a bilateral agreement that was signed between the present administration and the Korean government. In fact, they've gone to almost 70% between Korea and Nigeria with what is called e-government. They even have the committee that are implementing. Part of them is what you see that they are using as what is called TSA.
Okay.
Where everything that comes to the government goes into one box. So before you can pull out, you need it's not like the outlet is not like before where it goes out anyhow. It's called monitoring, and they can easily, just like our phone, you know, the moment somebody touch, you put your phone out, the moment somebody touch your account, in second you get it. That will be, if it's a fraud, it will only be that one. If it is a fraud, you say, it's either you call your bank or you rush there, the second one will not come in. Before, you will not know until the end of the month. By the time you realize, Emi or no bank, you can ask. So these are all what ICT has really brought to us. So in the e-government, I said it earlier on, it may not work with the present crop of people, but you can do it in such a way that the new intake, you let them know. So by the time gradually these people are facing now, they already used to it. And that's one of the reasons why I've been recommending that we should make computer or ICT compulsory in SSS. So that by the time you realize it, they're already guru. So that even if he's not taking that line, if you have his laptop or his iPad or his phone, he can do a lot of transactions, because the world is now on our palm. You can do all your transactions, anything. As I was coming this morning from Ogbomosho to this place, if I pick my phone, anywhere there's service, within 2-3 minutes, I've done one thing. Within 2-3 minutes, I've done, the service will go again. There will be a time there may be service everywhere. So anywhere you're in the aircraft now, when you fly, you can use your internet.
Yes.
You use your Wi-Fi. You use everything. So the world has become a global village. So it's something that, but with the old people, somebody that has already been 30, 35 years, it will be difficult. No problem. But the new intake, because luckily for all, they have a time limit that they will be eased out. By the time we set 3, 4, 5 years for ourselves, it will catch up. So we are talking of the future, because the world is moving. Nobody will keep or hold the world for you. You have to catch up. You have no choice. You have no choice.
Okay, one of our associates here that wants to ask a question to Mr. Isaac Brown.
Yes, my distinguished senator. Two quick questions. It was on cyber security. From what we saw, I followed the American election closely in this last one, and the biggest revelation of this American election has to do with the new frontier in cyber warfare. There's no doubt about the fact that the Democratic candidate, Hillary Clinton, based on all public opinion and polls, should have been the first female president. No thanks to the role that we believe was played by Russia, WikiLeaks, in terms of cyber warfare. The fact that a foreign government could expose private conversation of a chairman of a party protester, which really embarrassed Hillary Clinton, was a new frontier in the so-called cyber warfare. Summarily, we all saw how this internet will also be used to influence election. What lesson has Nigeria learned concerning this? 2019 is around the corner. It is possible we now hack into the private server of some of the leading political parties. And what is the Senate hoping to also do with respect to this? And finally, secondly, our highly distinguished rep, Fijabi, on the floor of the rep, brought up the issue of this multi-level marketing company, MMM, that are operating the internet. Funnily, the House did pass a resolution asking that this scheme be scrapped. But it's ironic, MMM is still alive on the internet. The business is still growing. Doesn't really show the helplessness of the control of our cyber space by Nigerian government. And what is the Senate also doing concerning this?
Let me start with the experience of what happened at the last election. I look at it from a different angle from yours. My own angle that I'm looking at it is that even if it is true, the Russians are able to hack into the American system and bring out a private conversation. I look at it that it's a lesson for you to be upright, either in private or public, of whatever you are doing. So, which means there's nowhere you can only run, you can't hide. That is my own perception. And it keeps politicians on their toes. If we say we want what is called check and balancing, which means whatever you are doing in life, you must be, what you can do in hiding, you must be able to do it publicly. That is one lesson, and that's one aspect. Secondly, the WikiLeaks story that you just raised, that revealed the email of Hillary, which eventually affect the election. For God's sake, that's politics. Look at Donald. Donald Trump said last week, he said, there's a difference between advertisement and reality. And most of the things that is on his block now, he has removed them. He has seen what is called reality. He has started changing his tones. So if that's what I'm saying, the impact of cyber security, if you use it positively, it will help the country. In any policy, it will have effects. All what you should do is that the positive effect, how it can help the country. On the motion and of being helpless by the House of Rep and what Senate is doing. Fijabi that raised a motion knows very well that when you raise a motion, we pass a resolution at both houses. We have enforcement. It should follow up by meeting whoever is the chairman of enforcement for them to go and enforce it, particularly if that aspect is part of law. Or, however, if you know that it's more than a little thing, it's a very big thing, you should turn this motion into a bill so that it will struggle with his other colleagues and make it to become a law. The moment it becomes a law, the sky is our limit, because there is a difference between a motion and a bill. A motion is just a resolution of the House that this is the way things should be done, and this is how we want it to be done, right? And then the bill is a law of the land that the security enforcement agent must be able to take action on it, and it's what is called a punitive measure on the bill. On the motion, it's only the Senate and the House of Rep committee that they have enforcement committee or summon the people who are involved to appear before the National Assembly. So he knows the next thing to do to be able to make sure that he achieve whatever he want to achieve with that motion.
Listen, Mr. Senator, are you a millionaire?
Am I a millionaire? Not a millionaire, I'm a billionaire in everything ramification.
Oh, great. Recently, you were commended by the leadership of APC in your state through your continuous and massive empowerment of your constituents, apart from your legislative duties. How did you come about the wealth to empower your constituents?
Well, you see, one of the good things about politics, when you ask me whether I am from a millionaire, I'll be a stupid man to tell you that I'm not a millionaire or a billionaire. Because we don't know the time, my father will tell you, you don't know the time Malaika they go. So, let me quickly claim it that I'm a billionaire. Maybe, and I say Amy 3 times. It's planning. And that is where experience counts. At any point in time that you are going into a place, either in politics or in business, you must have one focus. You must plan and know what you want and what you want to achieve. It's not everything that is money. There are easiest way you can do it. I won't tell you much of the secret because I will still use it, but I can reveal only one joker to you. Take for example, I gave all the 13 chairmen in my senator, my party chairman, I gave all of them a vehicle. Some of the vehicle were the vehicle I bought for my campaign. I didn't use it. And I was able to get more money to buy more. I bought more to add to the one I have on ground, 13. And I show it as a sign of I'm grateful to what you have done for me. If you look at it, it was a short period between the time I won my election and the time I did it. It was, it was a strategic thing that I did. Because if I've stayed for 1.5 years, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, some will say, Senate, yeah, you know our salary varies. It depends on the journalists you are meeting. Some journalists
don't even know your salary.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I say our salary varies. You see, it depends on the journalist. If you are meeting a social media journalist of no fees address, the statistics million every month. If you are meeting a journalist on social media that has name that probably can be treated, is 24 million.
All I met about is 15 million.
15, I'm coming. How do you know where I'm coming from? And then when you meet about a job, it's 15 million. I didn't believe it. And the last 2 weeks, I was on the program on channels. And I challenged the girl, Aibi. I said, when I was in the university, I was always running every Sunday to go and read Dele Giwa, Yakubu Mohammed, Sunday Agbase, Ebenezer Papa Tokwe, Ebino Topsi. I was always a guy every Sunday we want to go. You want to go and read them, this and that. Because they do what is called investigative journalism. And I told her, I said, madam, I'm disappointed in you people. You say, why? I said, simple thing. You want to tell me, since I was an answer friend, this thing I've been horned. So no any journalist is ready to take risk and to know that number one, it's not National Assembly that feeds their salary. That's number one. The salary is being fixed by revenue and physical mobilization. And you ask us to pass the law of secrecy, media, this law that you have, freedom of information that you have. So within effort, within the last 10 years, you want to tell me nobody has been able to come authoritatively to confront the senator that this is your fixed salary, this is what is going to your account, why this and this, and prosecute. Simple. She was just looking at me the way you are looking at me. It's a statement of fact. So why must as of 21st century, when we have all this, it's still a guess. It's still a guess. But I will tell you today that, including the former president, I'm not a bit impressed because he has his facts and he knows our salary is not 15. My salary, sorry, my own salary is not, you know, but don't ask me about this how much. My salary is not 15
million. But he said 15 million.
And I'm telling you that my own salary is not 15. Maybe he has some senator in his own house that they collect 15 million, but my own salary. So I'm not challenging you openly today. Okay, we can meet on the internet. Go to, I don't know that. What is due fees for senators and that's of friend? Simple. It's a simple. So that by the time you invite me and when they come, there was a day you lie that your salary is not of 15 million. I'm confronting you with it. Heaven will not fall. Heaven will not fall. Even your flake, Mike, Awo Infa, Dimba Igwe, these are journalists that when they are talking to you, when you are reading about their write-up, you feel that, not that the one will say, that's Senator Buhari, don't mind, they use Radu, go chop him, mama. You see, Senator Buhari stole on his way to media chat, and then that's why he bought the Radu. Fallacy.
Distinguished Senator, let me take you back to something you said some time ago. In an interview, you said if you were under probe, like the Senate President, you would resign. But sir, that hardly ever happens in this part of the world. What would you say is responsible?
Well, it depends on the any individual in anything. There are some certain people, even ordinary abuse, they'll tell you, I don't want all this again. Your backup, your upbringing, where you come from, what you aim for, what you want to be, or what you think you can be. It depends on you in life. It's not, like I just said now, it's not everything that is glitter that is gold. You are somewhere like now. Look at it. We gather here now. I've not met any of you in my life. I'm here. It's a choice. If I want to come to this place, it can make you. It can mar you. It depends. But you must be prepared. The only thing I did was that. Go there. Go and save fast. Your upbringing, where you come from, or the way you are, your exposure, assist in taking a lot of decision in life. So individual decision taking vary from one person to the other. The way I will react to things, the way I will spend my money is different from the way you spend your money. The way I will react to things is different from the way you react to his thing. Like you are now quoting me that probably I said, if I'm under probe. Let me ask you, you said it all. In Nigeria, since 1999 to date, we've been hearing this one, corruption. How many people have you punished for corruption? There's only one person that has been sent to jail on corruption in this country. It has even been quashed. That was Bode George. And it was quashed by Jonathan. So as far as we are concerned, it's zero. So it depends. But one thing we should try and do in this country, in that place where you were referring to, when they are accusing you, they are accusing you and confronting you with facts, not because of witch hunting, not because I hate you, not because of fallacy. So people will find it difficult to take that decision because they believe it is a lie. When you confront somebody in a developed world that 2:30 yesterday you were in this place, you are not supposed to be there, and you are in another person's wife place. Oh, what you will do with that? You will just say that. Something happened recently to a legislature in UK. I've forgotten his name. Do you know what happened to him? He went, at the time I was supposed to be in the chamber. He wasn't in the chamber. He was somewhere watching a nude video. He was just watching a nude video with another person, and they brought it online. When immediately they show him, he didn't even bother to go to that chamber. It's from that place that he sent his letter of resignation, because it was a fact. By this place, somebody will just send your picture, carry another person's head, put on your own, carry your head, put on your own, another person's on social media, start showing it, no facts, no proof. So we are able to reorientate our people to and reorientate the country on decency, on the right thing, we will be able to, we will reach there. It's not everything that we copy our brother we practice. No. Oh, no. It's not everything we practice, we copy our brother we practice. No.
I want to take you a little bit about your legislative duties. From 2015 to 2016, you have been involved in about 8 bills. Is that right?
You see,
personally,
you see, I'm not the one that is involved in it. The Senate is involved in it.
You have sent 8 bills in the Senate.
Yes, but like I said, when you go on media like this and you're a good legislator, you don't discuss individualistic on bills or on motion. It is always ideal when the press do their duty and say, well, Senator Umar, Senator Buhari, Senator Akin are sponsors to this bill, 8 bill, and these are the list of bills. It gives room for people to appreciate you.
I have the list.
And it will be very unfair for you now to be asking me, because some of these bills have not gone second and third reading. Your colleagues will wait for you. It's what is called collective effort. When it becomes a law, or maybe after my tenure that I'm going now, and you now say, your tenure from 2006 to 2000, so when you finish, or maybe I cannot use that my campaign data that I'm not going back. But when you start say, Buhari has sponsored you, they will wait for you. Now you are this one, okay, whether you want to go and pass it alone now. I'm being honest with you. That is the truth, because it's a collective thing. is a collective bill, is not an individual person's rule. It belongs to the Senate. But you cannot claim it if it comes to law when you are not back to that chamber. We cannot say in the 7th Assembly, when I was there, I sponsored 8 bills, 4 of them became law, 3 of them passed through third reading. That among when you are still serving and you still hope to bring more bills, I've not forgotten.
That will be our last question.
My name is Idowu Ayobele from Mega Icon Magazine. Sir, I have skimmed and scanned through your CV, and I must tell you, it's very impressive. Politics in Nigeria is regarded as a dirty game. Politics in Nigeria is all about pulling down, it's all about intrigues. Sir, what are you doing in politics?
Let me fix you. Your name, sir? ID. Politics everywhere in the world is dirty. If you are a good follower of American policy, you will know that our own politics is even clean. That is the truth. Look at the way, particularly even from the primaries of both parties, because I follow it very well. And then look at it when it became a war or a fight between Donald and Hillary. You can imagine. It's dirty everywhere. It's scheming. Football is a dirty game, but we watch it. Every round of us rush to go and watch Premiership. Something that can easily give you a blood pressure. I get me. Now, I've been on a more serious note now. I get me. If you fold your arm akimbo, and you said, politics is dirty, and you allow idiots to take over it, they will make love for me and you. Again, and this is where I blame the press. I blame the press a lot in this. You are the one to sensitize people. You are the one to reorientate the people. You are the one to be able to read the people. It is called determination that you can do for your country. Let me tell you what one journalist did for his country. The guy is called Arimiyao. Thank you very much. It's called Arimiyao in Ghana. He's a journalist. He has won a Nobel laureate. What he said was that, I want to fight against corruption in my country. And he disguised as a madman. He was staying every night, day in, night, in front of the houses of these judges. And he was recording the people that were coming in and out. He was monitoring them for 9 months. They didn't know. Immediately he finished, he documented everything, and it became a world-class film. 29 judges, including 4 Supreme Court judges, were expelled. Just our neighbor here, in Ghana, just our neighbor here, is determination. If we have, like, that's what I'm saying, you just mentioned 2019, the online media, you find a journalist, if they believe this is our country, and we need to fight for our country, it's not all of us that are clean. The moment we know that, hey, they are watching you, you stay on your toes, you be careful. You may not be 100%. No, none of us is 100%. But the most important thing, you must pass excellent. Between 60s, you have your grade. By the time you do that, you won't know what you are contributing to the country. You won't know that at the risk of facing the wrath of my colleague, I will mention one of the bills I sponsor. The bill is called Political Debate, Mandatory Political Debate. I'm taking the risk. I don't do this. I don't talk about myself. When I'm meeting the general, I want you to investigate me. The essence of the bill is that if we're able to form that commission, you have succeeded, if the commission is formed, you have succeeded in weeding out 50% of people who are not supposed to be somewhere that they would have loved, ordinarily they would love to come. Like, if I know that I'm going to face a panel, I'm not eloquent. I don't have it upstairs. I have skeleton in my cupboard. I have this, and then this is a free world. People will ask you questions. There's nothing you will do. First of all, you think twice. So, which means by doing that, that you eliminate the 50%. The other 50% will come another. Who is competent? Who can give us what we want? Again, and if people are sincere, though in most cases, it doesn't mean that the person that is doing better, it's just like exam, it doesn't mean that the person that came first is the best in class. Or the person that is doing better meeting for there. Some people, they may just be eloquent. The journalist may just like him. But there are some, yourself, your person will come out. They will dig it out. We were able to see Trump Donald Trump, the person he named. So if he does anything when he's there, it won't surprise us, because along that chain, along that line, we'll be able to identify who he is. I don't like it to know. That's the work of good journalism.
Sir, finally, sir. Sir, based on my checks, you are one of those politicians that believe in the ideology of Ashwari Bola Ahmed Tinubu. But recently, Tinubu has become somebody that many people love to hate. Sir, what exactly got you attracted to Ashwari?
Determination. Determination. Personally, in life, I appreciate people who are very determined. That's why I say I'm a human being. What I would love, it's just like you want to chase a woman. Okay, maybe me, I'm looking for a tall one. You are looking for a short one, fair or black, intelligent or dumb. Let me tell you one of my own attractions to a woman. No matter if you're ugly, I always want to agree. I want to, like this thing we are doing, I want to be able to talk to my wife this way, that she will contribute to the flow. So that when I'm coming out publicly to face people, who will not be proud for Michelle Obama to be your wife? You get them. So the attraction is what it depends on some people. If let me say Pepe, what's that? Papa? So they depend on him. So what attracted me to him is determination. Determination in the sense that when I was in the House of Rep, I was not in this political school then. And we now went for a meeting in Niger House one day. Himself, Puri Atiku. Himself, Puri Atiku. One person, I can't remember of it now. It was during the third time issue. And I said, you guys, we will be able to achieve it. At that time, we needed 120 to stop third time. We needed 120. The moment you have 120, we have stopped third time. They need, if we can get 120, they have only 119 plus the one, whatever they have. If we are short of one, they have one. And we have 132. Out of this 132, there are 8 of them from another part of the country that is not comfortable with. And I say from that 120 that we needed, we should remove that 8. From, we should do 120. I told you we have 132, and then we needed 120. That 132, that's what we should remove. It. How much do you have now? We have 126. 124. And I say, gentlemen, arguably we have 124. And I say, this 124, he called some of our guys, our 6 of them secretly. And I say, out of this 126 we are having, which 4 do you think are vulnerable? That's an intelligent person. That you think that, you know, out of the one, there are some that will die there. Mm-hmm. But which one do you think that they are vulnerable? They were able to identify them. When they were able to identify them, they now give them double check. He now said, while he was in Lagos State governor, early on, they went on a meeting one day, and Baba now said, look, scratch my back, I scratch your back. Look, don't worry, let's work together. I'll give you a ticket by a senator. All of them agree, except Bola Tinubu. Say, no, I know they scratch anybody, but let me use my own keke, my hand, to go and scratch my back. The other people that were ready to scratch people's back, they were former governor. He won his election back. Determination. That is only God that can do it. And then when you have that strategic thinking, you appreciate the kind of person he is. He's always determined, he's a fighter. So with that, and then when you now look at the way he come across, look at, from that word I said, determination, he succeeded in doing one thing that our great icon, the great man of the Yoruba history, which Awolowo, could not succeed in doing, because we didn't even understand him at that time. Trying that, look, if Yoruba man want to be president of this country, talking about figure, we are very minimal. That's the truth. If only we are going to use it in Nigeria. But let's do one chip. Let's play an alliance game. Let's play it with the North. Let's do Mumu for them. Let's be able to attract them. When we are able to do it for them, it will come back no matter what happens when it's our turn. But 8 years, He succeeded in doing that in 2019. Because had it been, he didn't go and form that APC with the like-minded people in CPC and the Northerner, I can say, would have still continued to be roaming about. But take it or leave it, either Buhari is doing 8 years or he's doing 4 years, whoever comes in, the chances of, if we are able to sustain this alliance, so the chances of Yoruba man even contesting an election, if they are going to be sincere, is high. And if him becoming the president of the country is again high. Determination. It can be you, it can be me, but it's laying down the foundation, and the foundation is what we needed to build on.
So, thank you so much for your time, sir. We are aware you have other engagements, so we will just allow you give your closing remarks.
Well, thank you very much. The closing remark is just only one thing. I'm appealing to you guys and every one of you in the social media to assist me, to assist my committee, to assist the Senate, and let's join hands together to fight this cybercrime in order to help our country. Whenever you think we are wrong or we heard, first of all, write to me, write to us. It may not even be me, any other person. Do it first. Give them money. Call attention. Media should be a corrective measure. If you're able to correct people, the sky will be our limit. You will be able to discipline the society. We should not use it as a vindictive measure against other people. If only we are doing it for this country, that just